Have you ever wondered which plugins consume the most CPU power in FL Studio? Perhaps you're having overruns, crackling sounds, and other performance-related issues. In that case, it can be beneficial to see exactly how much of your CPU each plugin actually consumes. And today, I'm going to show you how to do just that. The CPU meter shows you how CPU-intensive your project is. This is not the same as the CPU meter in Task Manager, though. This basically shows your CPU's ability to fill the audio buffer in real time. When this meter reaches 100%, your computer can no longer process audio in real time, and then you'll experience distorted sound, crackling, and so on. To figure out which individual plugins are most demanding on your system, press Play. Then, with the project running, go to View, and then Performance Monitor. Here you can see how much each plugin uses in real time. The most CPU-hungry plugins will be shown at the top. You can also search for specific plugins. In this case, you can see that there's a huge difference between the Fruity Parametric EQ2 and the FabFilter Pro, for example. If your computer is maxed out, then this can help you determine which plugins you should and shouldn't use. In this case, I could probably use more of the stock EQ and reserve the FabFilter for leads and other important elements in order to save CPU. When it comes to synths, I've found that Silenth 1, for example, usually consumes far less CPU than synths such as Spire, Serum, and so on. So having some awareness of this can be really helpful, especially if your computer is not the most powerful. Check out my other video about how to optimize FL Studio in order to get the best possible performance in 10 easy steps. The link is down below. Hit that like button if you enjoyed this video, and don't forget to subscribe and click the bell if you want to see more videos like this. Let me know if there's any particular video you would like me to make next. Thanks for watching.